This video is supported by Brilliant.org.
Now, I have spoken to Tesla about this phenomenon and the data we found here, and they basically came back with said, yes, we monitor it, and we're working on features and ways to improve it, so stay tuned. Welcome to Teslanomics. I'm your host, Ben Sullins, and this is the show where we look at data and we analyze and we try to understand how companies like Tesla and others are helping us improve our world by becoming more sustainable. So if you're into that kind of thing, consider subscribing. Today, we have a special study lined up that comes to us from an app that many of you use called Teslab. This is an app that is mainly focused on helping you get the most out of your Tesla. It's like Fitbit, where it helps you track your phantom drain, which we'll be talking about today, as well as other things like your efficiency on trips. And you can also do fun things like have the mayor of the supercharger and get little badges for whoever drives the most in a day or those kind of things. So if you haven't heard of Teslab, go check it out. That is the source. And I am an advisor to the company, and that's why I'm able to do this here today. What I have for you is a study that talks about how the Model 3 is compared to the S and X when it comes to phantom drain. Well, what is phantom drain? Let's start there. When you leave your car unplugged, whether it be like at work, like I am now, or overnight, if you don't have it charging or anything like that, it is gonna lose some energy, just like your phone does. It just gradually loses energy over time. In a lot of phones, we call the standby mode, and the standby mode is actually really good, where it'll last, you know, a couple days without being used. But what it's actually doing as it's sitting there is running some background processes, whether or not that's just checking that the device is hot or cold, and if it gets too hot, shut down or something like that. Also could be checking your email or checking a text message. And there's all kinds of little services that are running in kind of low power standby mode, but those over time do eat up your energy that you have stored in your battery. Well, a Tesla is really no different. So while you're not plugged in, it is doing all these kind of background checks. It looks at the cabin temperature, and if it gets too hot, it'll automatically cool it down. So there are all these processes running in the background all the time. And when you're not plugged in, those eat up a little bit of energy. And it's just a slight amount. However, when I did my range test earlier this year, I drove my Model 3 to zero. And in that test, I wanted it to be real world. So I stopped and got lunch. And in that 45 minutes or so, I lost almost 20 miles of range, which is a lot. That is a truly large amount to lose in such a short period of time. And that got me thinking, is this an issue that we're gonna see in the future? And that's what I wanna explore here today, is really what's going on with the Model 3 and whether or not it has improved since that early test I did after I got my car back in January. So first and foremost, let's get this straight. What do we call it? Vampire drain or phantom drain? I did a quick poll online and it looks like the majority of you agree that we should call it phantom drain. It's fewer syllables, it's easier to say, and it's not related to some mythical creature that sucks your blood. Long story short, we're calling it phantom drain. It's been settled. The debate is over. Okay, maybe not, but in any event, that's what we're gonna call it for the remainder of our video here and what you'll probably hear to it referred to online by lots of other folks. Now, my own results of just that one test weren't enough. Even one person isn't enough. And this is where Teslab comes in, because with Teslab, we have access to tons of data, and being an advisor for the company, I'm actually on the board. And these are some of the things we do from time to time, is we look at the data to provide studies and help people understand what's going on. You already get that as a user of the app, but then on a broader scale, we get to work with Tesla and talk to them about what we're seeing in the field. So it's a really cool thing for us to be able to do. So let's dive into the data here. First off, the study starts with all the different models, the S, the 3, and the X. And we have a couple different ways of counting these, but overall, we have 825,000 trips in this study for almost 5,500 vehicles. Now, what is a trip? So a trip typically in Teslab terms would be a driving trip when you, you know, drive somewhere and you measure efficiency during that drive. This is what we call a phantom trip. And a phantom trip here is essentially how much energy you lost cost while the car was in an idle state, while it was just sitting there. And so we're talking about phantom trips. And since TesLab was created and started helping people get this and logging all these results, we're at about 825,000 trips. And there are a substantial amount of vehicles. And you can see S is the most popular, X is the next most popular. And then the three, we have 362 Model 3s that use the app currently. And they collectively have racked up 31,000 phantom trips for us to look at. Now, we have some high-level stats here. We have the S with a minus 7.9 miles of drain per day. That's an actual 24-hour period. The Model 3 has negative 13.2, and the Model X has negative 10.9. So you can see that the Model 3 is a bit higher right now. However, like any number that is aggregated across 500 plus thousand trips or 500,000 of anything, it's not really telling you the full story. It's much more detailed than that. So this is where things get a bit more interesting. Let's look at this by the distribution of it across the different models. What you see here is essentially all of the different bins. So 0 to 2 miles of loss, 2 to 4 miles of loss. And you can kind of see that when I go across these bins here, what they are. So overall, the Model S has about 62.26% for the 0 to 2. And the Model 3 has very similar, 61.81, and the Model X is 63. So the patterns of these are very similar, which makes sense because obviously they have similar properties and all that. But again, we need to go another level deeper. And so I put this as a trend over time. And what we're looking at here essentially is the drain by day in a 7-day moving average for the different models. So you have in blue the Model S, and you can see this one is kind of the most mature that's been around for the longest, and it's pretty consistent. It goes up and down by day, and this is aggregating every Model S that is using TesLab, so that's actually worldwide. And you have, you know, temperature fluctuations and things like that. So, but overall, it's pretty consistent. Then you have the Model 3, which has much more volatility, and it really only started back in November of last year. So the data is very quickly becoming more normalized. You can see how volatile it was in the very early days with these big giant swings of high drain and then low drain. And then nowadays how it's coming out to be much more closer to at least a consistent amount. Then you have the Model X, which is right in between. Again, similar to the Model S, it's consistent at this point. It's been out long enough, and the amount of phantom drain it gets is pretty standardized. So the message I see here is that the Model 3 is becoming more consistent because the maturity of the software is improving and everything else along with it. Now, if you look at this not from just a pure trend standpoint, but want to see the projected future or this model, which is a linear regression model, you can see that, you know, while we do have some of those outliers that are really extremely high there, the overall trend is a downward one for the Model 3, which is great because that means that it's going to become more consistent and improve. Now, I have spoken to Tesla about this phenomenon and the data we found here, and they basically came back with said, yes, we monitor it and we're working on features and ways to improve it, so stay tuned. So just to put that out there, this data isn't conclusive of every single Model 3 out there, and it's not outrageous or telling some, you know, crazy thing that's happening. The story is that Tesla is aware of it, they are monitoring it, and they are improving it, and that bears fruit when we look at the actual data. So that's, I think, a really great story just about how Tesla works. And if you own a Tesla, you know this. For folks that don't own one and are watching this, that's kind of how it works, is these cars get better over time. And now we have real data. In fact, over 820,000 trips monitored in just this one study here. So the next thing I was wondering about in this study was if it changed dramatically by state. So I looked at that. And when you break it down by state, it's actually pretty interesting. Again, the S is pretty consistent. And this is across, you know, all the time that we were looking at there, so since November. And you can see that the Model 3 overall definitely is a little darker red, which means that it has a higher amount of drain, but it's still basically within the same ballpark as everything else. You have a couple outliers here, like New Mexico and then New Hampshire. But overall, you know, it's pretty consistent. And I think that's just a really great news for people that are getting their Model 3s now or in the future is that a lot of the folks like myself that had them early on and saw a ton of phantom drain, it's getting better. And you can see it's kind of in line with the other models. Then the next thing I got to thinking was, well, let's look at temperature here. And you can kind of see the spread of temperature across in this chart and the drain per day. So what we have right now with the Model 3 is you can see it's kind of on a higher temperature end and it's on the higher drain per day, which makes sense because they've all been delivered in California, or for the most part, as well as in California when they've been delivered, it's been warmer, right? Because we're going into spring and summer. So we don't really have a ton of data on this yet. And this, I think, was an interesting way of looking at that. Now, what we want to see is more like the Model S, where it's a bigger spread and overall it's lower. So I think that's what we're going to see over time as the maturity of the software improves. And the last question I really had here was on the color, if color really played a factor. In fact, a lot of you guys asked me about this on the Tesla Jedi group. And the answer is not really. The solid black has the most, which kind of makes sense. Black cars get warmer. The car has to regulate the temperature more, so then it would, you know, chew up more energy in doing so. Yeah, no big surprise there. And then the red multicoat coming in at the lowest, just behind the deep blue. Not sure why that is. I think, again, we do have a good amount of data to look at here, but over time and over the next, you know, winter and fall that come, I think these numbers will normalize out. I really don't think this will play that big of a role in the future. So the good news is that Tesla is aware of this, they're monitoring it, and it's improving. All of the data we have also suggests that exact same phenomenon. So if you're an early Model 3 owner like I am, and like many of the folks I've chatted with, you can recognize that this is getting better over time. And for those of you that are still waiting, be assured that in the future, your car is going to be even better than the folks like myself that have had it for a little while now. Now, I consider the techniques I used here to be fundamental to understanding the world around us. And I really think everybody should have them. Now, I've spent almost 20 years in the field of data science, collecting them and learning from various different methods. And of course, today there is a better way, and I'm really happy to share a new way of learning the skills and techniques, just like the ones you saw me use in this video. Brilliant.org helps you master the concepts in math, science, and engineering by solving fun, challenging problems, which help you get up to speed on topics like these quickly in an interactive format. In particular, they have a great course on machine learning, which starts out explaining many of the techniques I use when analyzing data. I recently went through this course, and it even refreshed me on some of the underlying formulas behind these techniques. One thing I also found neat about Brilliant.org was how they make the problems fun and interactive. Lately, I've honestly been spending a lot of time on here just going through these logic problems and having fun kind of learning these things and refreshing my mind on them versus watching YouTube or scrolling Instagram. It's been great. So if you'd like to brush up on your math, logic, or machine learning skills, or start for the first time, go to brilliant.org/teslanomics and sign up for free. And also, the first 200 people that use the link to sign up will get an additional 20% off their annual premium subscription. And perhaps you'll learn fun and new exciting ways to free the data. So thanks for joining me on this episode, and I'll see you back here next time.